Hi, this video is for those out there who have a DB Power T20 projector and want to mount it. Working with the DB T20 home theater projector. It's this little jobber here. The reason we're doing this video is because this machine does not come with any mounting holes. So we're going to show you how to mount it. The reason I now know how to mount it is because I've already ruined one machine. So this is my new machine. This machine was not ruined by mounting it. It was ruined by accidentally snipping that ribbon when I took it apart. So
the projector mount I'm using is a Pile PRJCM3 universal one, and it only cost about $17. It mounts from the ceiling or can mount from a wall, and you can modify this mount in a variety of different ways. These are images from the internet, just to give you a better idea of what the projector mount looks like.
All right, so this projector came with a bunch of different parts, bag with all the different screws that fit through all the holes. This is your ceiling mount, your top bar, your extender bar, and then additional pieces that came mounted to the main piece here this way, but I took that off so that I could mount it since this is such a small projector. But these are just all the pieces. You can basically take all these bolts out and just kind of rearrange it the way it works. But in order to get it to fit in such a tight, small, close area, you're going to have to modify it down, and I'll show you that in a minute, how I did it. This is being used for a specific application in an RV trailer, which is why it has to be so small and so tight and at an angle that's coming off the wall, not hanging from the ceiling. That's why I've modified it. You can hook it up whichever way you want. You will have to take off this plate in order to put just the bars on. Normally, there's a little slider that comes out, but it's way too big to fit on this little projector. So you'll not need this. If you mount these screws down through here, they'll hold on because they screw right in. These have threaded feed on them, so you thread right into them. So depending on what size your projector is, again, for this one, my projector's so small that I need these really short feet that come with it, paired up with a long one. So a short one in the back and a long one in the front, or vice versa. And I rigged this differently so that it would work for my application, but you can follow the directions that came with the box. As long as you're using the feet straight off the base, it should work. So here's the parts of the DB top of the projector. The inside pieces, the mounting, the hardware board, protective cover, and then the inside. You don't need to get into here at all. I'm just doing this because I've already messed this one up, so I'm showing it to you. Again, the way I messed it up was by breaking the ribbon when I took it apart. As soon as I broke this ribbon, this entire LCD panel was useless. So I've had to buy another projector. Showing this to you so that you don't have to buy another projector and you can just put your screws in. The location of the screws, you'll see, the first one is down here at the bottom. You can barely see, so you can focus in there. So the thing to note is that it's missing anything vital down in the projector. So if you come up through the center of that foot pad, it'll miss things there. If you go over to this other side, again, you'll see down underneath, that's the bottom center of that foot pad. That's where that drill bit came through. Okay, so taking out the lens so you can see this, and the cooling brick. Okay, so with that out of the way, you can see that the third hole is down right there. It sits underneath the cooling piece, and because this is up, the cooling piece sits on top of this little wall here. So as long as your screw doesn't come beyond that, and it's about a half inch down, but just use really short screws, and I'll show you the screws I have. Okay, so here's the new projector. You can see the old one in the background that is in pieces. And the reason I'm showing this to you is so that you don't have to have two projectors with one in pieces. You can hopefully just do this in one shot. One thing I will show you here, warranty void if damaged. If you decide to do this, you are on your own. So realize that I'm just showing you what I learned, and whatever experience you have, if you screw up your own DB projector, that's on you. So first thing I'm going to do though, with this new one, I'll lay it down so I can get these out, is just pull these little feet out, and they're really sticky, and you pull them out, and you can see on the new projector there is no hole in that spot. Let's get the upper one. This is, again, the upper one is where the lens is, so this one will have a screw in it. That one comes out a little easier, and there's that little screw head. That's the only one that will have an already screwed, or already have a place for a screw. Get the other two out. Oh, they're hard to get out. Put those aside. So now you have 4 3-foot holes ready to be drilled. That fourth one, you just need to take the screw out. So let me get my drill ready. I'm using a 1/8 inch drill bit. Carefully in the center, and just very slowly drilled it. And as you'll feel it go right through, and do not push very far in, because you do not want to go anywhere further into the components than you, into the case than you have to. Again, just very slowly. There it gave. And the fourth one, or third one anyway, sorry. There it gave. Alright. For the next part of this, I'm going to take out that small screw. Use a little bitty screwdriver, obviously. And when you take it out, it is indeed very tiny. In order to put the mount back on, you're going to need a longer one. I believe the kit, luckily, has another one in there. And what I did to make sure it didn't go farther into the setting was put a little bit of a bushing on it so it sits above. It'll go through the metal. It'll have the bushing, and then it'll only go back into the threaded area just a touch. So you'll need a little bit of a longer screw for that one. And again, you're going to lift it up so it doesn't go in there. And it'll go around, actually it'll go on top of the metal, not in there. Get that out. But that's the one that'll fit. So make sure you have a screw that can fit in there. For these other holes, I found just a short little screw. These will need to go in. The metal is going to sit above here, so you need to have a little bit of length. A little bit of length, and then we're going to screw that right in. So that way it'll go into the body of the plastic, and will be lifted a little bit by that foot flange, but it will not go into anything in damaging the internal components from what I have found on my machine. If you're doing a DB T20, you shouldn't have any problems, and I'll go ahead and film this again afterwards and show you that my projector is indeed still working. Alright, so again, for my application, I'm going to be having my projector film upside down and because of the way this is going into a trailer, so I'm going to be using this stand as a guide that I can remove back and forth. But basically all we're going to do is just put this is a metal screw. It is a metal screw. Into those corners. I do not recommend you use anything other than a hand screwdriver because you do not want to overcrank these. Gotta get the next one in. And I also would not tighten all of them all the way down till you get it sort of stabilized. Park my arm. We're going to put in our screw that is by the lens. So this is where we need a little bit of a lift. Different screwdriver and that tiny threaded metal screw that's already not going into plastic, it's going into the existing hole. Cinch these down until they hold. You're not trying to kill it. This is a very light projector, so it does not need to be cranked on. It just needs to be stable. Put the last screw in the back side if I can get it. That's it. That's enough to hold that little projector on with those 4 feet. And if you drilled into the feet holes for the DB Power T20, you should not have hit anything. Okay. So here's our test. Here's our hanging projector. We just got it stuck to the piano bench for the moment. Give it the test and see if it still works after drilling holes into it. There's your startup and your fan and your signal. Now it's upside down, so you're going to have to fix that. But it is possible. Now if you can do it upside down, good luck. There we are. It's right side up. And there's your projector. Now, it's on the yellow wall, so it's terrible, but get the idea. So, hanging projector, securely on there. DB Power works just fine. One other thing to note about the projector is that if you loosen this screw, you can pivot it back and forth to get the right angle. Not the projector, but the mount. And you can also pivot it left and right. So this mount, once it's secured where I want it in my trailer, and it's going to be removable since we're driving down the road, I don't want to have it shaken, so that's why I want to be able to take it out. But these screws allow you to adjust back and forth the base. So if I need it to go whichever direction, I would just loosen these. So good luck. Don't destroy your machine.